One of the most amazing habitats on Earth is found in warm, clear, shallow waters of tropical oceans worldwide. Tiny cup-shaped animals called polyps live in colonies, and when they die, their skeletons form a hard, stony branching structure made of limestone. This is coral, the growing, living, incredible under-the-sea structures that provide shelter and food for many marine animals. Three types of coral reefs form in the warm tropical waters. Fringing reefs form along a coastline. They grow in shallow water. Barrier reefs grow parallel to shorelines but farther out, usually separated from the land by a deep lagoon. They form a barrier between the lagoon and the seas, making travel difficult for ships. Coral atolls are rings of coral that grow on top of old sunken volcanoes in the ocean. They begin as fringe reefs surrounding a volcanic island. Then, as the volcano sinks, the reef continues to grow, and eventually only the reef remains. Groupers, clownfish, and hundreds of other fish species dart in and out of the colorful reefs. Anemones, attached to the coral, sway in the ocean currents. Crustaceans, like shrimp and crabs, scramble about looking for tidbits of food. An occasional sea turtle glides by looking for a quick meal. And inside the coral itself, tiny microscopic organisms called zooxanthellae color the coral and provide it with essential nutrients. They also help the coral secrete limestone and remove wastes. Other organisms, such as tube worms and mollusks, build up the coral further by leaving their skeletons in the coral when they die. Hard coral is made of the same material as classroom chalk, calcium carbonate. This coral must live in clear, shallow water because the organisms that provide it with nutrients are actually a type of algae that need the sun. Brain coral and elkhorn coral are hard corals. Soft coral, on the other hand, looks like colorful plants and graceful trees. They can live deep in the ocean. Coral fingers, red sea whips, and yellow Gorgonia sea fans sway softly to and fro as the ocean waters move past them. Coral reefs develop in warm water, usually near land in the tropics. They are very sensitive and prefer temperatures between 70 and 85 degrees Fahrenheit. Higher temperatures cause the algae living inside the coral polyps to die. Only the skeletons remain, causing the coral to appear white, which scientists refer to as bleaching. In the past few years, because of global warming, an unusual number of bleaching events have occurred worldwide. Not only do temperature changes harm the coral reefs, but healthy coral life can be destroyed by sewage, stormwater runoff, fertilizer leaching into the ocean, and petroleum in the water. Careless boating, diving, and fishing also break up the coral reefs. Coral reefs grow very, very slowly. Some of the deep-sea coral grow only a centimeter a year. It has taken hundreds of thousands of years for the coral reefs along our coasts to develop. Some of the best-known reefs are the Great Barrier Reef off the northeast coast of Australia and reefs off the Florida Keys, which stretch almost all the way to Cuba. Coral reefs serve as barriers and protect our coastland from erosion during storms. As you have seen, they are also a unique habitat for a multitude of sea creatures. And scientists have just started studying the properties of the biological compounds and microbes that exist only in the reefs. Perhaps chemicals in the reef will give us clues to curing diseases or solving some of the Earth's problems. If the coral reefs are constantly exposed to damage by humans and global warming, the strain will be too much for them, and we and the wildlife that live amongst them will lose them permanently. The reefs protect us and other wildlife. Let's protect them. After all, it's your planet too.